and welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan. And today we're going to be looking at energy and the first law of thermodynamics, meaning that we're going to be starting to learn about how it can be transferred and some of the basic concepts. So this is an introductory video just to go over some fundamental concepts. So where does this all start? Well, thermochemistry is the study of heat that is absorbed or released during a chemical or physical change, meaning that if we have a chemical reaction, that energy or heat may be required to make it happen or for it to be given off, or if we're trying to melt or boil or try to condense try to change the physical state of an object, heat may be required. So we're going to be trying to look at a little bit of that. And the big reason is because these types of changes are important to your everyday life. They're all around you. Right? If you're just sitting right now in your room watching this video on your phone or on your laptop, you right now are metabolizing the different food that you've ingested recently. Maybe if you're drinking water, it's going through the different pathways where thousands upon thousands of chemical reactions are occurring every single millisecond. Now, from there, energy is either being created, it's probably generated from trying to break down that food, it's being converted, right? If you had to drive to get to school or to go to work or to do anything, you burn fossil fuels. If it's the winter time and you need to heat your home using, like, maybe if you have like gas heat or if you have electric, right? That is different things that convert energy to help you be able to use it. Or if you just be able to use the basic necessities that you find in your everyday life, right? To make your cell phone or to make your laptops or to make your home. To produce all those things required energy to do them, right? So it's all around you. And that's what we're going to be looking at in this video and trying to understand the basic concepts of how we can describe it, how we're going to see it in chemistry. All right, let's take a look at these different concepts. All chemical reactions obey the following two laws. One is the law of the conservation of mass, which we've covered in previous videos. And then now the law of conservation of energy, which is also known as the first law of thermodynamics. Now, what does that mean? Well, essentially it tells you that the total energy within a system is constant, meaning that if I have a system like a chemical reaction, or let's say even yourself as a system and you're interacting with your surroundings around it, well, essentially energy is transferred, right? So if you put your hand on a cold surface, you'll feel that surface begin to get hot because your body heat is being transferred. Or if, let's say the vice versa, if you put your hand on a hot pot, you can feel that really quickly by burning your hand, right? That heat, that energy is transferred. Meaning that essentially everything can be, all energies can be converted, because energy cannot be created or destroyed. It is always converted, and essentially it is something that links all of us together because of this constant conversion. Now, energy can come in many different forms, and that's what we're going to be looking at and how we can actually measure that and understand it. So let's try to take a look at the different types of energy and how we can see. It takes a lot of work to get up there, and it takes a lot of energy to do so too, right? So in chemistry, work is defined as change in energy, and it's resulting from a process. Now, those processes can occur in many different ways. A lot of them, depending on the type of energy, can really come from all kinds of different sources. So the first general idea of it is thinking back to, let's say, if you had to take physical science in high school, or even just basic physics, one thing that you learned about is that total energy is essentially a conversion between potential and kinetic, meaning that potential energy is how much energy you have stored within a system, right? It's all about where is like an object positioned. So let's say if I had my pen up here and I'm ready to drop it, it has all the energy stored up that it could be ready to drop. Now, just by sitting here, it's not doing anything, but the second you drop it, that energy is being converted, right? So it's going from potential at its highest point, and as it's going and moving and gaining energy as a result, right? It's moving with a velocity. That's when it's converted to kinetic energy. So potential, kinetic, is your total energy in a physics system, how much it moves. Now, what exactly does that picture kind of look like? Well, the way I like to picture it is thinking of the scene from The Office where Kevin is carrying all this chili into the office and drops it all onto the floor. Well, him carrying that pot and holding it at its highest peak, that has all the potential energy in the world to eventually be converted to kinetic and spill all over the floor. And then once it's back on the floor again, not moving, now it's back to potential. It's a conversion between the two systems. What other forms of energy can you possibly see? Well, we can also look at chemical energy, meaning what is being stored within bonds of molecules and compounds. And this is where, as chemists, is something that we continuously seek and try to understand, especially as it applies to, let's say, whether it's burning something, as I show here, or even thinking of metabolism and how we make you go, right? Nutritionists are constantly trying to figure out, okay, how many calories are there within this food item? How much can it possibly have? Can it actually help do what you're trying to do, right? Calories is a unit of energy. So are joules. We're constantly trying to understand how much is stored. Thermal energy is always associated with how much movement is there within a molecule or an atom. Molecules move, electrons move, they vibrate, they change. The warmer they get, they move even faster and faster and faster. The pressure that they're putting on an environment is going to change as a result. Two, this is something that's constantly moving and flowing, and it's associated with essentially the entire world. Now, things that we've learned about in other videos in the past, energy from radiant energy, so the electromagnetic radiation, let's say from the sun or from waves that are essentially giving their energy, as those different photons are being emitted, right, that energy can be absorbed within these chemical systems as well. So it can come in many different ways. Almost all chemical reactions, they can absorb, or they either absorb or they release heat. Now, when this or release energy, and the way that they, when they absorb or release energy, it's in the form of heat. So one thing that we're constantly trying to measure in chemistry is that, is this transfer of energy between two substances at different temperatures? And what do we call this letter that we represent this as? We use the letter Q to show, hey, this is heat. And the units for that are in joules. Okay, so J-O-U-L-E-S. And we use the letter J. This is an SI unit, or so this is something that we could manipulate using prefixes. So you can have millijoules, kilojoules, megajoules, all these types of things as well. And then we can also convert this to the system of calories too, where one calorie is equal to 4.184 joules. So calories is more in the common in the US and as an imperial unit that we use to measure how much energy there is, let's say, in food. Now, some important things to note about thinking of heat and how it actually works. Well, there's some little obvious principles about it, is that, well, heat flows from hot to cold, right? You can see that in your everyday life. You know, if you're really, really hot during the day, you want to try to cool off. So what you might just find yourself standing in front of the refrigerator on a really hot day trying to cool off. Heat is absorbed, meaning that this Q value that we're going to define through subsequent videos after this, if it's a positive value, that means that heat is being absorbed by your system and that this is endothermic. If heat is being released or coming off of you, you are being exothermic, right? So if you kind of hold your hand close to your face, you can feel the heat coming off of your body. Those are exothermic reactions. Essentially, you're constantly releasing heat. So the way that we can actually show these and try to define how these systems are is, the first thing is defining what the heck is a system. Well, a system is anything where the reaction is taking place. So I drew these little boxes here to show, okay, so I have a blue box and a red box, and that is our chemical system. Now, when it comes to, let's say, you as a system, the area around you is your surroundings. So you can feel, let's say, heat giving off from you. So like, this is kind of an example of you, right? So you feel heat coming off of you. Another example of this is like an exothermic process is if you have a heat pack or a heat wrap, and you feel that heat coming off you. If you crack open the pack and it starts getting really, really hot, well, these little orange lines here are showing that, okay, heat is being released as a matter of fact when this happens. It'll be a negative Q value. When, let's say, if you have an ice pack, well, it's going to be the opposite idea. When the chemicals mix together in an ice pack, it's absorbing heat from everything, making the surroundings feel cold. So the inside is hot, the outside feels cold. So it's all going in, it's absorbing that energy. And we're going to be looking into that in future videos as well. Now, one thing you might see here is that there's a letter H written in something that's going to be seen as well. Well, this stands for the term enthalpy. So what enthalpy is essentially, there is a chemical form, there's a formula for this, it's a physics term. It represents heat energy, and it's related to pressure and volume. But to simplify this course, what we are going to be doing is that heat, or Q, is equal to enthalpy, because we are dealing with we're assuming a constant pressure and constant volume to simplify our calculations. So essentially, delta H is going to be equal to your energy, which is equivalent to your reaction heat in this type of equation. So we're simplifying it. So if you see an H value, it represents a form of energy. Okay? And this is what we're going to be using to describe changes of phase, so like boiling and freezing and all those kinds of things. So some final notes on this is that one thing just to keep in mind, energy cannot be created nor destroyed. This was a crash course in thermochemistry, because something that we use in types of introductory chemistry, but it's just to be understood that heat flows from one thing to another. So we don't create it, we don't destroy it. Thermal energy is not the same thing as heat. They sound the same, but they're not. Thermal energy depends on the kinetic energy of a molecule, meaning how much is it kind of dancing around. Atoms will continuously move and bounce, and go from all over the place. The colder they are, the more they stick together. The hotter they are, the faster they move around. So one thing that we will see here is that heat is all about how energy is being transferred. So going from hot to cold, thermal is movement. Heat is essentially how energy is transferred. So one thing is when we use temperature, essentially it's the measure, if you remember from my temperature videos, the measure of the average thermal energy of an object, meaning that, let's say, if a molecule is very, very hot, it's moving around all over the place. So these molecules are kind of bouncing into the walls. They're moving all over the place. This means that this has a very high kinetic energy. Versus this one over here, you see that they're all stuck together. They're frozen in place. They're not moving. So this is a low kinetic energy, meaning that this is a low temperature versus a high temperature on the left, okay? So this is going to be a picture that we're going to be looking at quite a bit, that as our temperature is changing, the thermal energy changes, the molecules move and behave differently, depending on that energy that's being associated with it. So this is just a general overview of the terms, things that we're going to be seeing in thermochemistry. Thank you so much for listening. I hope that this video helped you a little bit, introduced to the world of thermochemistry. As we dive further into it, you'll see a lot more about how energy can be converted and used in different applications. So thank you so much for listening. If you haven't yet, hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you all so much for being around. See y'all later. Bye now.